fucking go. Ugh.
Cowboys. Does my mic work?
Yeah, we can hear you.
Oh, thank you, thank you. Come out, you papi pompi. It's a big swing. That's quite loud, actually. You want me to make them run here? I can call for them. Fuck, do they see anything in this fog? Well, fuck you then. Why isn't it stereo? So. Hey, cowboys.
Leave.
Yeah, we got work here, right here. It's red. Thank you. Google. Tyst. Hej Google. Tyst. Clowns. Oh, we're inside of. Wakey wakey.
I'm alive.
Welcome, love.
You crazy beast. I love you, man. This was amazing.
It's expensive, let's take it. Ooh, just one griffin. That's a very expensive team. There we go. Big boys, big boys, big boys, big, big boys, and pretty big boys, yeah, pretty big boys. Ka-ching, baby. I can't believe that the baseball bat in the Vitaly is carrying me to 6 stars. The baseball bat is really good, to be honest. It really is. This loadout is amazing. It is actually really, really, really good. Let's see, is it enough for sharpshooter? Yes. Do we want vulture instead of fire removal? Yeah. It's bigger. I'm like climbing to the high ranks with with no meds. It's actually quite fun. That's the fun thing with that one. Cool. I like it. Hey, cowboys.
Hello.
Oh! Oh, lovely. Two down.
I have more water.
Only wheelie guy left. Two guys dead. Cha-ching, baby. Boys, I'm sorry. shot, man.
Too bad my team was not waiting for me.
Got that team away. Yeah, it was hard to defend there, to be honest.
Break time.
Det kunne sig.
Well, well, well. Let's see. då titta på något kul medans jag äter.
The Witcher is dead. It's over. It's finished. It's completed. It's there's no more Witcher. It's done.
A while back, I made a video called The Witcher is Doomed, one that was covered by Asmongold. Thanks, dude. Well, here we are,
well,
7 short
it.
Months later, and the beginning of the end is here.
Nerderotic.com.
Greetings, you over 786,000 practitioners of common sense and the 40%
Hi.
Who haven't subscribed yet. I want you to
Maybe
look
I
for a lot
game.
Of I told you so's and...
Okay. F*** you, I was right! I was right.
Over the next year, currently, Indiana Jones and the Dial of Dysentery is the flop heard around the world.
I'm sorry, but like, bro, why are we exhuming these old actors that are like, dude, this is a fucking 70-year, he's got no business being in an action film. Fucking stop it. Let it move on. Stop trying to appeal to this. He's 81. Wait, Harrison Ford's 81 years old? What the fuck? Let him go. Jesus.
Competing with The Flash to become the biggest bomb of the year, and it is certainly the...
Did he just put a baby in a microwave? I thought you weren't supposed to do that.
Biggest financial disaster in Lucasfilm's history, or in this case, I should say, herstory.
I have some major problems with this movie. One of the problems I have with the movie is that Phoebe's character was an asshole.
Wow.
And that's a good thing for Netflix, because fewer people have noticed, A, The Witcher Season 3 even came out, and B, that it's abysmal. The beginning of the end is here.
The chat says that he's leaving because he doesn't agree with the storylines that the writers have been developing.
No.
If that's the case, I can completely understand that, because Henry is such a huge fan of the games and the books, and the writers on the Netflix series have chosen, for whatever reason they did so, to deviate quite severely from the books and the games. I personally don't understand the choice.
Now, I think that deviating is totally okay. The problem is whenever you deviate and it's worse. That's the real issue, isn't it? It's not that you deviated, because of course you deviate. I think that you should deviate whenever you're committing something onto cinema, but it's that it's bad.
This could have been avoided if you listen to the fans, just like with Kathleen Kennedy over at Lucasfilm. If you had listened to the fans, you had multiple times to fire her after The Last Jedi, after Solo, after The Rise of Skywalker, after she fired Gina Carano. But
I think that people at this point with Star Wars, like, the only good new character was Kylo Ren. I liked Kylo. I thought Kylo Ren was great. None of the other... I didn't give a fuck about any of the other ones. I didn't watch The Mandalorian, though. So I could be wrong about this.
Beyond all rational explanation, she is still in charge.
Yeah, I don't
and
know.
Look where it's gotten them. We've also seen this with Chris Chibnall and the first female doctor played by Jodie Whittaker. Those two were only shown the door after the show.
Doctor Who, worst ratings in 31 years. I don't know why people don't understand that, like, the gender of a character is, like, a very core element of the character. You can't just gender swap a character and expect people to be like, oh, okay. It's like it's a massive fucking element. Like, why are we pretending like it's not?
Completely cratered. Same goes for Alex Kurtzman, who's been killing Star Trek now for years. Yes, he did have a recent success with Picard Season 3. One he had nothing to do with, but now he's gone right back to killing Star Trek, and now two of his shows have been canceled with more to come.
This kid's got to go back to preschool.
Michelle Yeoh is set to star in her own Star Trek movie.
Oh, f*** it. Oh, shit.
The problem that a lot of these things have, like whether it's Star Wars or Star Trek or, Indiana Jones, is that the IP is tied to, like, William Shatner or, why am I not thinking of his name? Or Sir Patrick Stewart, of course. Yes, of course. Patrick Stewart. Yeah. It's tied to them. And it's the same within Star Wars, right? It's tied to the main characters in the original Star Wars. That's what people really give a shit about. It's not Joe Rogan, okay? That's not Joe Rogan. Anyway, I think that's a big issue. because they're not able to make new characters that people are engaged with in the same way. Now, in my opinion, I liked actually Chris Pine as like, who was he? Wasn't Commander? Fucking like, he was the replacement for William Shatner, basically. I thought he was great. Yeah, Commander Kirk. Yeah, there you go. I haven't seen the movie in like 10 years. I actually thought that the fucking, what was it? The second one with Benedict Cumberbatch, who was Khan. I actually thought that was a good movie. I liked it.
Right.
And now Netflix is doing the same thing. The second Henry Cavill started having a problem with Lauren Schmidt Hissridge's writing, she and her entire staff should have been gone. Admittedly, despite it having problems, I did like season one. Gave it a 7 out of 10.
I like season one as
well. This is the portion of the video where I get some I told you so's.
Yeah.
I told you so. I told you!
I earned that. Despite my age, I'm still capable of being a sweet summer child. Now let's do a brief recap of The Witcher's road to failure. After a very successful season one where Netflix thought they had their Game of Thrones, we started...
Yeah, I don't think that the show was as good as Game of Thrones. I don't think it was even remotely close, but it had heart to it, and I think that it had like some really good moments, and it had decently good characters. I enjoyed it.
Hearing some concerning comments from Henry Cavill.
With the shift of the showrunner's vision, where it's an ensemble cast more so than a singular lead, and the perspective is shifted to be almost more of a Cirilla Yennefer perspective. And so it's about...
Yeah, nobody who gives a fuck. Like, I'm sorry, but, like, if you're watching The Witcher, like, maybe it's just me, but, like, I'm watching The Witcher to watch Henry Cavill cut up demons and, like, monsters. Like, that's it. And, like, Yennefer is hot, which is nice, and Ciri is, like, his daughter, and so it's, like, you know, you've got some nice moments between them. But other than that, Let's get back to the, yeah, cutting up monsters, and yes, let's get back to that. Very simple.
Finding my character's place within that vision and making sure that I do everything I can to be as faithful to the source material as possible within the structure set out for me.
That was Henry trying to temper our expectations, and that's a good thing because season two came out and they absolutely butchered the book Blood of Elves after Lauren Schmidt Hissridge completely ignored the fan complaints of there not being enough Witcher in The Witcher. She decided to put less Witcher in The Witcher for season two. Then we heard from former Witcher.
Like, I wonder, like, how are the executives letting this happen? That this is what I never understand. Is like, things are just obviously going to shit. Like, because they did that Witcher Blood Origin, right? And that was really, really bad. Like, did anybody watch that? I don't think anybody, but like, because I saw I had like a 0 out of 10. I was like, I'm not going to watch this.
To writer Beau DeMeo, that writers on the show were openly mocking the source material. Then on October 13th of 2022, Henry Cavill announced he was leaving The Witcher, and it all gets worse from here. Shortly after that, a petition was started with over 300,000 signatures. Netflix, you must keep Henry Cavill as The Witcher and replace the writers instead. Then after that, we started to understand why Henry not only left, he ran. Blood Origin was released with a whopping 13% audience.
I thought it was lower than that. I did. I thought it was even lower than 13%.
Score on Rotten Tomatoes and a 1.4 user score on Metacritic. Making a pretty good case of being worst fantasy series in a year that Willow and the Rings of Power came out.
Yeah, whatever happened to Willow? I heard that they were redoing Willow. And that's also, by the way, remember what I was saying earlier about how they're trying to keep old? It flopped? It got canceled? Good, it's stupid. They shouldn't have done it. Yeah. Yeeted and deleted. It's ridiculous, yeah. Like, I remember watching the original Willow. It was great. I loved it. But, like, we don't need another one. Stop it. Just stop trying to make a quick buck on exploiting nostalgia. Like, you want to make a show about Galadriel? That's nice. Then call it something different. Like, give her a different name, make it a different universe.
But that was just a taste. What did Lauren Hissridge and her patriarchy-smashing writing team have up their sleeves next? This brings us to The Witcher Season 3.
Didn't even notice.
First off, props to Henry Cavill for being a true professional. Part of being a professional is showing restraint, and I'm sure the first time he saw that script, he wanted to set it on fire and tell him to piss off. In season three, just like in season two and actually season one, everyone's after Ciri. As the synopsis goes, as monarchs, mages, and beasts of the continent compete to capture her, Geralt takes Ciri of Sintra into hiding, determined to protect his newly reunited family against those who threaten to destroy it. Season 3 is based on the book A Time for Contempt, which is appropriate because Lauren Hissrich has obvious contempt for The Witcher and men in general. At this point, you should just call the show The Witch Her, because this is clearly the Yennefer show, and it always has been. One more time.
Is it that bad? I haven't seen Season 3. Is it really that bad? Yes, it's bad. God, I don't even know. Season 3 is the worst of all. Holy shit.
I'm Az.
I told you so.
Yennefer, Ciri, and their sidekick Geralt are all together again, except there's a little problem. I seem to recall last season that Yennefer betrayed both Geralt and Ciri. And then Yennefer goes so far as to try to sacrifice Ciri to get her magic back. But apparently Ciri and Yennefer worked it out before the season started, and it only takes a couple episodes for Geralt to forgive Yennefer. But why take the time to have Yennefer authentically redeem herself after, quite frankly, butchering her character last season when you could just blow past it and get back to girl bossing?
I think that's always a mistake. A lot of times characters do that. They'll do something that's like obviously like a really bad thing, and then they just kind of ignore it as if it didn't even happen. Off-screen resolution. Yeah, anything like that's always really bad.
Glotra as Yennefer and Freya Allen as Ciri are fine, but they're given nothing to work.
Thanks, Espo.
Going fast.
Ooh, what's this? It's time for funny boys. Ooh, I like that. I respect a man with a build. Look at this. So loud. Hey, Cowboys.
Am I going up against Sixtorf now or not? like the craziest sitting down.
Thank you.
They went from ports. That's pretty cool of them.
Thank you.
wrong? Yeah, there we go, homie. That's how you do it. Of the killing for the drilling there, I mean. Those shots were really, really far away. Yeah, they can't, they must be down quite a lot. Wait a minute, that guy is shot. That guy. Not crazy. Easy. Thank you. I can't remember that I killed three people, to be honest. Fucking baseball bat, bat, bat. This setup is so... It's really good. People underestimate the power of the bat. Gonna try to win you, I guess so. I wish that this game had unique weapon stats. That would be so fun to see how many people you clubbed. It feels so good, that's the problem with it. Yeah, one more time. I can't stop, it's so fun. cowboys.
Hmm?
Hey, cowboys.
Hello. I think I shot you.
Sorry?
Yeah, I'm pretty sure I shot you yesterday.
Yeah, I think you did.
Sorry.
It's okay. Just don't do this in this game.
I go to the supply quickly and still got these patch marks on.
Yeah.
We gotta walk over half the map, let them come to us.
Yeah, I agree.
We just passed the wall to the left, so south side.
I
Was it taken or?
Okay. Nah, not mine. I guess they found it when they rotated back that one guy.
Nice.
Let's hope the other ones go south as well, huh? Or do you want to push to the bounty?
I can go if you want.
Ah, it seems to move now. Yeah, let's try to intercept them.
Yep.
There's a trade. Necro.
Great. Ashen fuckar mig helt. Yeah, they did a good job actually. I was hoping for a better shot there. I'm tired. GG.